In a recent podcast, Joey Ingram spoke with Ebony Kenney, fresh off her massive $1.7 million score at Triton, which we'd expect to be a time of celebration and joy. But things ended up falling off the rails, with Kenney abruptly cutting the interview short. So what exactly happened and where did it all go wrong? Today we'll be doing a GTO analysis of that discussion to find out. For some background, this part of the conversation begins with Joey talking about that there's a new crop of ambassadors like Ebony that are seeking to change the poker community for the good, and Ebony indicates that one of her main goals is to make poker a safe, inviting place for women, and that this will require an effort of everyone in the community to come together. And this is where we'll start listening in, as Joey uses an interview technique called an echo to reiterate what she was saying to elicit more information.
Okay, so your thesis is more women should be playing poker, and because other people aren't treating them well, then that needs to stop. People need to treat them better at the poker tables. And you're going to be the one of the people who leads that change and becomes one of those voices who not only educates the men, but also women in why that's important and how to go upon doing that as a solution. Versus how it's been in the past, where it's been pretty, misogynistic in terms of the way women are treated, in terms of the general attitude at the poker table. You know, poker's a pretty out-of-line game.
So as Joey is speaking, we see Ebony look off into the chat, and she does not seem to be pleased.
Live poker games are pretty out-of-line people, so.
What? Who is this person? Is he a mod?
Who?
Dark Angel.
I don't know.
Can we, do you have a mod in the chat?
Yeah, I got a mod in the chat. They're working. I don't know, this chat's crazy, bro. I don't know what the chat's
like,
talking about.
Like, people are wild.
Yeah. Everybody got their own opinion. Ebony, listen, everyone's got an opinion. You know, what makes your opinion more valuable? That's what I always say. Like, who gives a fuck what I got to say about these things, right?
At this point, it appears that Joey, likely a few edibles in, isn't quite clear what was said, recognizes that Ebony is not happy with someone in the chat, but kind of brushes it off in an apparent attempt to get her to do the same. But this is where things start to go south, as Ebony views his response as being dismissive.
Joey, we can't like have comments like women need to stop being bitches and fighting each other, and then you say like everyone's got that.
So Ebony confronts Joey, telling him that he cannot have comments in the chat about bitches fighting each other. And here you see Joey say okay, with his posture immediately changing in an apparent sincere attempt to understand what Ebony is talking about.
Her own opinion. Okay. That's exactly why the poker environment is as toxic as it is right now, because we allow comments like this to live and we just
Which comment? The women need to stop.
He said women need to stop being bitches and in fighting and support each and every one of the women playing. Like, why does he need to use this kind of language?
That's a woman. That's another woman.
Why does she need to use this kind of language? And it doesn't matter. Why does she need to use this kind of language? This kind of comment shouldn't live from a woman, especially.
So Ebony now elaborates on why she didn't like the use of the word bitch, because she believes that these types of comments are what is causing poker to be toxic to women. She then takes another step by shifting the onus onto Joey, implying that it is his responsibility to ensure that comments like this don't live.
Like,
So people shouldn't be allowed to say certain things if people disagree with it.
No, what I'm saying is that calling people names shouldn't just be dismissed as having an opinion. That's still attacking, that's still bullying, that's still outrageous behavior.
So after finally realizing what she was talking about, you can see a shift in Joy's presence. He clearly does not agree with her view and challenges it by asking her to frame the principle or rule that she's seeking to enforce. It appears the main conflict here is that Joey views this as a disagreement of opinion, but Ebony views it through a different lens. She characterizes the comment as calling people names, attacking, bullying, and outrageous behavior. But let's pause for a moment to consider if that is true. Did this female mod, who apparently is by all accounts a very nice person, call anyone a name? Did she attack or bully anyone? Now, there are two ways that Joey could react to this. He could just capitulate and agree with what Ebony is saying because she's the guest and his friend. Or he could consider her actual words and craft his response based on his honest assessment of its substance. And spoiler alert, Joey chooses the latter.
Mm-hmm. What's outrageous?
So,
certain words are outrageous.
Joey,
no, I'm trying to really understand what you're saying, right? I mean, I hear a lot of people say this on Twitter all the time. And I let anybody say whatever they want to say.
Yeah, but when you allow people in your community to just call women bitches, mm-hmm. it creates a mindset that is toxic and facilitates this exact kind of behavior, which is exactly why, like, in my, like, my Twitch community, this kind of language is like, we call each other, like, we're the bad bitch army. I use all the curse words. Everyone's allowed to curse as much as they want. But what I don't allow is people to call other people names and, like, call people, like, bitches and whatever in the way, like, with their intention behind it.
So Ebony explains that the mere use of the word creates a mindset that is toxic, which has peripheral effects in the community, but then seemingly contradicts herself by saying that she and her community use this word all the time. She then clarifies that what is most important is the intent behind the use of the word, which I wholly agree with. But that raises the question, what exactly was the mod's intent? In the context of the discussion, it seemed that her intent was to actually support exactly what Ebony was saying, that the whole community needs to come together, both men and women, to facilitate an environment that's more friendly to women. So I think it's fair to ask, why was a negative connotation immediately assumed? And if the intent was actually important, why didn't they just stop the conversation and ask the mod what she meant and give her a voice and the opportunity to clarify?
And so, like, you really do kind of, like, dictate how your, like, what level of toxicity you allow in your community. And that's all I'm saying is, like, people, like, this is, like, part of the, like, you also have a responsibility. You are a content creator. And when you allow this kind of language to happen, it's, like, like, what's the cutoff, right? Like, if someone drops the N-word, like, you're probably going to, you know, probably going to delete that. But it's okay to call women bitches.
So Ebony puts the responsibility of the community's words squarely on Joey, and again, the question is, how should he respond? If he truly believes that the use of that word in this context was benign, which he should have more insight into because he actually knows the mod, should he just cave and delete it as a sign of respect to the guest? Or does he have the right, with his own community, to determine that this particular use was not offensive, and therefore err on the side of allowing his community as much freedom as possible to express themselves? After all, that is the whole point of a chat. I don't know Joey's particular thoughts on the subject, but I would guess that he views his community with some level of kinship and has a valid desire to protect, foster, and grow it.
Like,
I don't know.
Where do we draw the line?
Yeah, I guess that's a good point, right? Everybody got their own opinion on things, so I'm not that about that censoring that hard. I used to be maybe more about censoring everybody and if people disagree with me, cut them off. But at the same time, like, I'm way different
censoring.
Now about that. I don't agree with
it's
that
about,
level
it's
of censorship
not about censoring
anymore.
People, for me, it's not about censoring people. For me, it's like, hey, like, my Twitch community, right? Like, when I'm streaming, Twitch is my home, right? So if you come in my home and you're going to be disrespectful to people that I care about, you can either play by the rules or you can leave. Right? That's just the way. And it's just like, hey, I'm not going to allow this type of language because I don't speak about people that way in this house. And when you allow people to do that, you're saying, hey, it's okay that you can talk about people this way in this house. That's all I'm saying. So yeah, you allow some bad behavior in your house.
So Ebony says it's not about censoring people, but that seems to be literally what she wants him to do. Deleting or prohibiting expression is the very definition of censorship, even when it's for a reason that you believe is justified.
I mean, I guess who considers it bad, right? I mean, everyone, all right? I mean, that's how I think about these things. So I guess I wouldn't like it if people were trying to tell me what I can and can't say or can and can't do in that kind of situation. So when I look at that and say, okay, do I want to start telling people what they can and can't say? In the past, I may have thought more that that was a good idea, but I don't necessarily agree that way anymore. But obviously, these are our channels, so we're allowed to operate that however we please.
Yeah, for sure. But when you, like, when we ask, like, why more women don't play poker, I mean, this is also part of the problem, Joey.
So now Joey is part of why women don't play poker, because he allows people to say bitch in his YouTube chat. Some have criticized Joey for being defensive here, but in truth, that is quite a serious accusation to level at someone, and so it seems reasonable for him to push back to defend himself.
Yeah, it makes sense. I mean, that
you have one of the loudest voices in poker.
No, I'm retired. I don't have one of the loudest voices in poker anymore.
You still have one of the loudest voices in poker, and you allow this type of, you know.
Oh, another woman to say the word another woman to say the word bitches in the chat while I'm talking with you, and me allowing that. You said I allowed that lady to do this. That's what you're implying.
Okay.
Right? Because I don't think that'd be true. So we got the mods working hard. This chat's out of line, bro. Listen, I mean, the chat on YouTube, people are crazy on YouTube, right? So I don't know where these guys come from. But I understand what you're saying, right? You as the leader of the community, you
I'm not
do.
The leader of the community.
No, I'm saying, but but my community, right? I'm leading my community. So I need to be able to dictate what people say. And you're saying
it's
that
not,
if I allow them to say certain things, then that's
it's not
a...
not needing to dictate. And so, like, you really do kind of, like, dictate how your, like, what level of toxicity you allow in your community. Okay, so for example, like, Ninja allows people to, like, say the N-word in his chat.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he's okay with this kind of shit. And he's just like, oh, I can't help what people say. But you can't help what stays on your, in your chat.
Sure. Yeah.
You can't, you're not controlling what people say, but you're allowing to like, you're just like, hey, I'm not cool with this lingering on my, in my channel.
So Ebony compares Joey's actions here to Ninja allowing people to say the N-word in his chat, but is that comparison fair? I think this encapsulates a large part of where these types of issues come from. There seems to be this trend where someone will take something that is very clearly wrong, conflate that with something that is in a totally different category, but maybe adjacent to the wrong thing, and then treat both as the same, thereby eliciting the same response. For example, the idea that words are violence. By all standard definitions that have been in existence since the beginning of time until just recently, this was not an accurate statement, but today it is a commonly used phrase, and it has real impact. If someone violently attacks you, you have a right to physically protect yourself in response. So when words are conflated to violence, those words are now eliciting a disproportionate response, even to the point where it becomes justified to physically attack the person that uttered those words. And it seems like we're seeing a similar conflation occurring here. In certain contexts, bitch can be extremely degrading or demeaning, but that was not this context. This mod didn't bully or attack anyone. She was actually enthusiastically expressing her agreement that we should be creating an environment that is better for women. Despite that fact, the mere use of the word elicited a triggering response, and this response is a consequence of a hyper-focus on words and language. Even when well-intentioned, which it often is, a hyper-focus on words actually causes people to become more hypersensitive to those words, sometimes irrationally so. And this creates a vicious cycle. As people become more hypersensitive to words, it then causes well-intentioned, empathetic people to hyper-focus on those words even more, and so on and so forth. At the end of the day, words are literally just noises. If you called someone that doesn't speak English a bitch, it would have zero impact on them. Words only have the meaning that we ascribe to them, so by hyper-focusing on words, all we're doing in reality is just elevating the power that those words wield. And whether we like it or not, we all have a part in shaping how these words are received, including by deciding whether we should reinforce something that has been misconstrued or misrepresented for the sake of appeasement. Essentially, it is a self-fulfilling prophecy. If you tell people over and over that they should be deeply offended to hear a certain word, guess what? They will be more inclined to be offended when they hear it. In light of that, perhaps it would be wise to venture in the opposite direction and affirm to women that they are strong and resilient and can hear a distasteful word that is not directed at them, brush it off, and continue stacking people.
Yeah. Yeah,
there's
makes sense.
Difference.
I like it. Okay, I see what you're saying. I see what you're saying. Shout out to my mod, my own mod, my own mod. Another woman got it in trouble. They got it in trouble. We'll see. I don't know. I mean, if someone disagrees with that thought, what do you think?
Idea that it's okay to call women bitches, like that, like it doesn't matter who says it.
Right. Well, I know, like, I agree with that, right? If someone says bitches, if someone's calling people bitches in the chat, you're probably going to agree to that comment. I would agree with that.
And there we have it. Joey agrees that if someone had actually called another person a bitch, then he would have gotten rid of the comment, but that is not what happened. And we need to keep this in mind. Joey didn't use the word, and his mod didn't direct the word to Ebony. The words weren't wrong. They were adjacent to being wrong, and then elicited the same response. So the question is whether Joey is obligated in some way to participate in that conflation when it is contrary to his own beliefs and values.
But I don't know, that lady, the lady's fire up. See, Dan, what? She got me in trouble like that. More censorship's better, I understand. That's my takeaway. Everything matters. Every word people say matters. And if people are spreading a certain message and you allow, I mean, it's kind of like that with shilling, right? Promoting, you're associated with these words, you're associated with these phrases, you're associated with the sayings that people are saying and the message that they're putting out there as well.
Wait, so, we're comparing shilling to just like allowing.
Well, I'm saying me, right? For me, exactly. That's what I would say. I would say if I'm promoting this kind of behavior, then that's the kind of behavior I'm promoting in my chat if I'm letting people in the chat use it.
Okay.
Would you? I guess that makes sense.
This is a wild reach.
What do you mean? No, I mean, that kind of come back to that, but I'm basically promoting that kind of language in the chat is what you're saying by allowing it to take place. So. I'm just trying to understand it better. It makes a lot of sense, but I'm just trying to get to that point. So, but yeah, guys, Berkey started with the daddy. I don't know what he said, so not sure what it was, but we'll have to talk more about it later. But yeah, can they say bad bitches? I don't think you guys can say that either. Should we block those guys too?
All right, I'm going to go, Joey.
Yeah, okay.
So Joey basically points the finger back at Ebony, comparing the idea that he's responsible for those that he associates with in the community to the idea that Ebony is responsible for those she associates with in her promotion, i.e. ACR. Ebony really doesn't care for that comparison, and she ends the interview. Now, some may look at this situation and say that everyone's subjective view, even if wrong or irrational, should be acknowledged and addressed, but others would call that enabling. Perhaps Joey could have handled the situation in a more friendly or diplomatic way, but I don't think that should mean just swallowing his own concerns and agreeing with Ebony's position. And at the end of the day, Joey is only human, and I think he may have been a bit offended himself with her calling him out when he thought he did nothing wrong. I wonder if those that have jumped on Joey over this incident believe that he is also entitled to those feelings, and if so, whose offense wins out? Should know me well enough. This better have my money. Play down, call me all my blood. Pay me what you want me. Ballin' bigger than LeBron. Bitch, give me your money. Who y'all think y'all frontin' on? Like black.